My name is Joe Kerbelski, and I am an AMR driver. AMR is automated meter reading. The AMR driver is mainly just residential meters that had transmitters in them, and you just drive through and pick those up with the rig that's behind me. Meter reading is more of like the handheld reads, so you're going out and you're reading commercial accounts, you're reading water meters. The route will change kind of depending on what needs to be read for the day and how the day goes. As an example, like I could say, oh, I plan on driving it this way, but all of a sudden there's road construction on this and this road's closed, so I have to avoid this road. But for the most part, it's the same meters every month, but the driving route's never the same. Our whole county is split up into what we call cycles, and the cycles are set up to where we can read them in one day. That's kind of how we designed the system, and it works pretty well. I really like working outside. I like being out, you know, out and about. It gives you a chance to interact a lot with our customers, and we kind of can work through issues that they may be having. My day-to-day when I arrive is I'll walk in and usually look at the daily schedule that Dan has done, and see, you know, what am I doing that day? What do I need to be prepared for that day? What routes am I doing? Where am I going? Those sorts of things. And then we'll kind of sit down as a group and have a tailgate and talk about what it is we're doing that day. But then after that, we grab our handheld processors that have all of our routes in them. I get a USB disk that has my route in it. I take it to my truck, put it in my computer, load up the route onto my computer and see where it's going, and then make sure that my work matches up with each other. Then head out into the field, usually stop, have to get gas or something like that, make sure that we're equipped for what we're doing. We work with every single department that's in this utility almost. We get orders from customer service to go check on meters that, you know, maybe the customer feels they're too high or too, you know, something's going on. If I'm reading my route and I find a meter that's not giving us a read or it's giving us a bad read, that gets forwarded over to the meter department. So we'll work really closely with them and really try to make sure that, you know, the jobs that each department needs to do gets done. And the same thing goes for the water department. Sometimes we'll open the vault and the thing's just spewing water out. We'll call the water department and say, hey, this meter's blown up inside the water vault, if you guys can come out and fix it. We even work sometimes with like the shipping and receiving people. They'll send us out to do deliveries for school deliveries for the field trips. So we kind of do whatever's asked of us from any department that there is. I think a lot of people think that our job is easy. It has easy parts to it, just like any job does, but I don't know if anybody's ever tried to go out and read 200 to 300 water meters in a day, and every single one is just full of dirt and moles or flooded. Sometimes we'll come back in and we are just covered head to toe in mud, but you know, the important thing is that we got the read on it and those bills are able to be sent up and processed. In my time working in field service, I think I've been bit 3 or 4 times. We had a goat, like it was in this field that had a water meter, and the goat like came over and like started trying to like eat the clothes off of us. You know, you're walking through a field and all of a sudden you step on an ant nest or a beehive and the bees just come flying out, or you get bit by a whole bunch of ants. It doesn't go that way every day, but we definitely have our days. One thing I've learned from the years of doing this job and trying to provide the best customer service that we can is that we really got to take the time to listen to what the customer wants. Because if you can deal with a customer's issues that they're having that are way down at the root of whatever their problem is, the end point of it will end up taking care of itself, because you've taken care of something, you know, that's way down at the base.